Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. In today's video, I have to sort the problem out with my pedestal drill. The Jacobs truck on the pedestal drill has been running out since I've had it, and I can never figure out what's wrong with it. So in this video, I've decided to get to the bottom of it and try and fix the run out. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. With the spindle in the up position, the run out on a dowel held in the Jacobs chuck is, maybe 0.4 of a mil.
This has got worse over the last few years. So I will strip the chuck out, see where the run out's coming from.
So I've put the Jacobs chuck, just hold it on the tang in the vise, or to remove the chuck from the Morse taper, what I've done is I've just got a nut and bolt, put that down into the chuck jaws, tighten the chuck jaws up on the nut, and with a socket just turn the bolt . If it's tight, or it won't, when you turn it won't come undone, just hit the bolts with a hammer to shock it, and it should break the seal. So once you've removed the chuck, the next thing I want to do is hold this in a Morse taper, because this centre's been drilled out, so I can't put it between centres, and check whether this taper is running true to the Morse taper, or whether it's the chuck that's been just poorly made, and the taper on the inside of the chuck is not running true to the jaws. Here's a tip. On this Morse taper, the centre hasn't got a tang on the end, so you can't use your drift to remove the centre. So the way to get the centre out is to just drop a nut in there, then you can put your drift on top of the centre and extract it. That's the number 2 to 3 Morse taper. I've checked the spindle's clean, so that fits in there. And that's the 2 Morse taper which holds the Jacobs truck. So I'll put that in there. Just make sure it's in. So the next thing we need to do is set a dial indicator up on here to see what the run out is. I've put my magnetic base on the top slide with a dial indicator, and I'm just going to put this expanding mandrel in the headstock so I can turn headstock from the other side with the handle. I'll turn the headstock. You can see the run out on that is 0.03, which is just over a thou.
So nothing like the run out when fitted in the pedestal drill.
So the next thing I need to do is see, with the chuck on there, a dowel hold in the chuck jaws, whether it still runs out. Fitted the Jacobs chuck to the spindle, put the dowel in, so I'll check the run out on this. You see now that dowel is running out 0.07, which is about 3 thou. Nothing like it was running out in the pedestal drill. So that's proved that the chuck is okay.
I've put the chuck back in the pedestal drill, and I'll just rotate it. You can still see the run out. So obviously there's a problem with the spindle on the pedestal drill.
To remove the spindle, undo this nut on this side with your washer. Take off the spring housing. Then on this machine, I can pull the handle and the gear out in one go. Hold the spindle, because there's nothing to hold that spindle from falling out. That's the spindle. This part goes through the pulley at the top of the machine, and the drive comes through the spline on there. You have a bearing in this end and a bearing in this end. So what I want to do now is see whether this spindle is running out to the outside. I've just set it up on the lathe. What I've done is put a V-block on the top slide, the spindle and the quill in the V-block, mounted the dial indicator in a Jacob's chuck, and I just want to check the run out. You see there, it's running out about 0.04, which is about a thou and a half. That's the play in it, which is about 0.05, two thou. So that seems to be okay. When I fit the chuck in the spindle, you can see the run out I get on that dial indicator, half a millimeter. So for some reason, the chuck's not mating up to the spindle correctly. I've checked the spindle run out on its own, and that's running within a couple of thou. So something's wrong with the chuck and the spindle mounting.
I've put some micrometer blue in the bore.
When I fit the chuck in, you can see it's only touching on the outer edge of the hole. This end, there's no marks at all, so it looks as if the Morse taper in the drill spindle is only touching on the front. So that means when that goes in, depending on how this lies, this top bit lies, it'll give you the run out. Let me explain the setup. I've put four jaw chuck on so I can center this bearing diameter here, and the other bearing diameter is just at the end here. Because there are different diameters, this diameter, that diameter, there's another diameter here where the bearing goes, and another diameter right on the end. I can't set my steady on this and then slide it along. So I've clocked this up true as I can get it, which is about 0.01, half a thou, something like that. I mean, this is the diameter where the bearing locates. If you can see from that, it doesn't locate on the back end because that's clear. Locates on the front end. So I'll use the bearing diameter as the steady area.
I'm moving the steady in until the dial indicator moves.
Now I know that's just touching. And I can nip up that one, do the other one the same again. So that's just touching there. Nip up that one. Let's lock up the top of the steady. Lock that up then. And the run out on the bearing diameter is 0.02, 0.03, which is about a thou and a half. I'll check the run out in the bore. .075, which is 3 thou. Okay, to roughly set the taper, what I've done is I've put a centre in the Morse taper that I want to machine, revolving centre in the tailstock, and a Morse taper between centres, so I can now come onto the Morse taper and then wind it across
and roughly set the compound slide to the correct angle.
Okay, I've done the taper. I found out what the problem was. Let me show you. The problem was this hole, this slot here. What was happening with this Morse taper? They hadn't gone deep enough on the hole here. I've just machined that deeper. What was happening? This was hitting the end of the slot and still wobbling about at this end like that. Now I've machined a bit more out the back. It's gone in further. It's gone up about another quarter of an inch. They'd just machined up to here. So the last quarter of an inch wasn't deep enough. So although it must have been very close, but not close enough. Now that .15, which is 6 thou.
And considering the chuck is running out about 3 thou, I don't think that's too bad. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.